This video is about how to use the remote VEConfigure feature in Venus 2.17 and later. You'll need a Venus device, such as a color control, connected to a Victron inverter charger, and be registered on the VRM portal. Once you've opened up your site, select the device list, wait for it to load. You can see here we're at 2.17. Make sure that VRM two-way communication is enabled. This is set on the Venus device itself in the Settings Services menu. There's the multi we're going to change the settings on. And scroll to the bottom where you can see Remote VEConfigure. This will take a moment while the VRM consults with the device. And I can now download the settings. The file has now been downloaded. In this case, we've saved it to a folder called VRM Remote Test. You can see it has the file name extension RVSC. This is a special type of file and needs to be opened in VEConfigure. Let's do that now. You can open the file by double-clicking it. You can see in this case there's a new version of VEConfigure available and we should use it, so I'm going to download it. These are now the settings available. This is slightly different from what you'd normally see if you'd connected to a multi-grid with VEConfigure Mark III adapter. There's no real-time data, but the settings are all here. I'm going to make a slight change and adjust the AC input current limit from 18 to 17 amps. I would like to save the changes to my remote file. That now has the updated information. If I open it again, you can see that it's now at 17 amps. Now that I'm back in VRM, I can now upload the updated file. In this case, the multi-grid doesn't need to be restarted because the settings I changed aren't significant. If you were changing significant settings though, the multi-plus or the multi-grid may restart itself and you may lose power if that's how the site is supplied. So be careful. You will receive a warning about this. Be aware that if the site is remote, the power supply, if it's interrupted, may also interrupt the internet connection. This won't affect the configuration of the device or the uploading of the information. That'll happen before the device restarts, but it might mean that the site's offline for a few minutes while everything boots itself back up again. You should let someone know if they're on site and you aren't that you're about to shut down their power supply. Now the status has finished writing the configuration, we can reload the VRM. Heading back into the device list, I'll now load the remote console. Heading into the multi-grid, I can now see the input current limit is 17 amps, so my setting has been correctly changed.